Middle Creek Poets. This is a beautiful little chapbook that I tried, and I really mean this, not to sell, and it's letter set, and Michael McCoy, a student here, designed it, and I understand he came last week. He lives in Manteo. I've not seen him in years, and it's maybe the most handsome, but this is a battered copy. St. Andrews did 500 copies under the logo or name in print, Blue Coop Press. And I wish I had fiddle-dee-dee. I have two pages on the Blue Coop that used to be here. Well, since Ron isn't here, I'll read him. I'm doing the draft. Of something for Ron and all the Hall of Fame people. I'm just having fun. But this part is part of what I'm putting in it, and it's for Ron. He doesn't have this. I'll give it to him next week. It's from a little chapter. Does St. Andrews still do the governor's school? I taught governor school one summer. I needed some money. And oh my, I was interviewed up at somebody in Raleigh and said, how do you know you can do this? Chuck Sullivan was doing the literature part, poetry. It was to teach, what? Epistemology. And I said, well, you're looking at somebody who doesn't know anything. And he believed me. I was just thinking about this epigraph. I should probably cut it because it's really tough. Epistemology for Ronald H. Bays. This is a little quote from Plato's Republic, Book 7. Imagine the enlightenment or ignorance of our nature in a figure. Socrates, the allegory of the cave. I believe in an aristocracy which has a grease pit, a vultocracy, with one supreme monkey. I wrote this during governor's school. Autonomous under us all, including a little sideshow symbolic of nothing, I can imagine. Constructed so that the matter loses energy, lying limp as a goose's neck on a block after the axe has fallen into the collective names of concept and confession. Where all statements of creation are wrong, except the one stoical holding out for the eye. Appearances are phenomena, positive and pragmatic, as the old predestination which holds me